Hello, welcome back. So as you can see, in the mid-game we're going to have a lot of problems building stuff, but I kind of cheated my way out of this part of the game because, guess what? You can just build a floor on top of everything and you can just leave the roof as they are. Now, what kind of determines the maximum height of your building and your total structure? Well, to be honest, it's mostly going to be your infirmary or your hospital. Because the first things you'll build will always be the same, meaning 4 height. Like this, and then the floor will be 5, and then it will mostly depend on what else you want to build, but I can almost 100% guarantee you it will be because of the hospital. As you can see, we have 5 beds over here just in case we have more people injured, and once you progress more into the game, you see that people will have a lot more HP, so that means they'll need a lot more time to recover. And another problem is that we need another furniture, so I don't think you can get away with a smaller infirmary. So it's 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is annoying. You know what, let's just do it like this. This is much easier to count. As you can see, this is 10 wide. We have to go over here. I guess I can make it a little smaller, because in my case it has to be lofted. Oh, minus even actually, it doesn't really matter, does it? Now, I can potentially make this smaller, but as you can see, it would get into the way of my other buildings, and I can probably lower it a little bit, but look at the window. The huge window is also a big part of this. So, let's look at this as well. So, probably you're going to need 9 height for your rec room as well, or the commons room, because this is a fully upgraded common room. How's commons? As you can see, the main layout will mostly depend on the huge window. Of course, you can make 3 large windows, but it's almost the same resources, so you'll kind of get stuck if you do it like that, because look at this. 9 frost glass, 10 frost glass. So the large rectangular windows are harder to make than the big one. So yeah, I recommend you just build them at the edge of your base, the common room, and of course the infirmary. And then you might as well just build something on top of it, and it will look kind of weird, but trust me, it's the easiest way to do it. Who is nearly starving? Oh, he's eating, okay. Other than that, for the atelier you'll need decorations, which you'll need to put over here. And this was a nightmare, because you have to destroy the roof. I don't recommend you build anything with a wonky roof, because wonky roof only adds luxury to the room. And you generally don't need a lot of luxury. As you can see, the wonky room adds a couple of more luxury points compared to the normal one. And I built 3 of these thingies, the conical stuff, the finial. That made this an atelier. Now, again, it will depend on your game. Some of them will require lofted, some of them will require skewed. So, again, it's a randomized keyword. So, you can just copy the base layout if you want. As you can see over here in the bottom rooms, I don't have anything that could be useful. I'm thinking I'll need to build a few... Fog is advancing. Yeah, we can deal with that. Or we cannot deal with that. I'm thinking of building a few rooms like the classrooms. Look, this is an intermediate classroom, it's a little bigger. Because at this point of the game, you'll have just certain students who have, let's say, a task to study alone. So it's easier to just make 2 classrooms than rather than modify the schedule and do crazy stuff like that. Also, I've seen a lot of people, they just play the game and wait for stuff to be built, but in my opinion, you should always have a more proactive role in the base. I think you'll have to give direct orders. Why are you not eating, you idiot? Going into some soup. I'll probably change the auditorium into something else, or I'll make it smaller, because definitely it's a waste of space. The dining room. Well, that's a good question. Can you get better dining rooms? And the answer is not really, because you need to make it a private one. It will be very hard to do a private one for the sale or whatever this is. And this will be private, lofted, and towered. So that means over here we'll have to put everything on a little ledge or something, I don't know, I'll have to think about it. But yeah, let's just look at the design again. So infirmary over here, down over here is just a four tile and you can build whatever random rooms you have, and then you just move them upstairs over here. Drafted in private. As you can see, you can kind of cheat your way out of it just by building another room over here near the staircase, and the staircase goes up to here. And over here I'm just waiting for the scrivener desk. I need ash parments, which I need smoke sticks. Smoke reed. Oh, it's called a smoke stick, okay? So yeah, the game in the mid game is kind of weird because I need a lot of ice petals and a lot of... It's okay. Ice petals and smoke sticks. And apparently the smoke reed will stop spawning if you go too far away from your base, so I'm not sure what the deal with that is, but I think they only spawn mostly in the first area of the game, which is from here to about here. So if you just build over that area, you basically are stuck in a bit. That was disappointing. Over here we have the scarecrow. On the other side of the base, I make sure no crow nest spawns. So over here we have the crow nest because there's nothing for them to eat, and over here I generally destroy them. So that fixes that problem. Over here is the conservatory, which is just for more recreation. And I have to keep the stair bedroom, because the stair bedroom is the only place where the teachers will sleep until I get them the private rooms. But it's going to be annoying to make private rooms because you need a very high tier bed. The atelier is over here, kitchen is over here, just a ladder. It has to be like this. I think you can just put some chests over here if you want. For example, you can put some chests over here that will only have the food materials. And a few chests. Well, I guess this is not big enough, but usually you want a room big enough to have some chests with materials and to store the things you build, because that would be much more efficient. But at the same time, since you have so many carriers, it doesn't really matter what you do with them, because look at this, everyone has finished their tasks. So I can even remove stuff from a... Yeah. I can even remove stuff from a chest and it will still work. And the chest will be... Someone will come and put those things out of the chest, and then the quilted carriers will take them to the rightful place. Also a tactic just to wait a little longer, because as you can see, I don't have the smoke sticks to do that and I need them for something else, so might as well just wait a little bit. Other than that, things are going kind of bad, because as you can see, I lost my raven gold people just because they are impossible to keep happy unless you have the private bedrooms. But let's look at the private bedrooms, how hard they are to make. So 5 to staff, 25 to staff, but this one requires private, lofted, elevated, 60 luxury, which is a huge amount of luxury, and one canopy bed. Other than that, we can make the well, I guess we can make some private quarters, but as you can see, this is going to be a little trickier. The bedroom can have two beds, which is very, very helpful, because it still needs to be private, or the private quarters need to be private and elevated. I guess you can just make an elevated room by... Let me see if that works. So, IS... How tall are these guys? You might as well make it 4. I don't think they can walk through a room if it's only 3. Might as well make it a 4. If you're wondering what am I doing over here, oh, you'll see in a minute. Luxury private. So we need 2 for the bed. And they also need 3 windows and 1 or more large windows. So that means we need kind of like a size of 4. Okay. I'll have to reload this save, because this is not the proper way to do things. If that will work. I have my doubts, but it might work just as it is. of a floral foundation. It's fine, it will work. Let's try and see if we can build a smaller rooms like this. Again, this is just for testing, because there's no point to actually build it like this. It's actually counterproductive. Let's cancel that, and all of the rooms, I guess, will have a 4 wide. Yeah, that's way too tiny, so let's make 4. And that should be more or less everything we need. Maximum wonkiness to the roof, because we need more luxury. And at this point of the game, you also need a lot of other things. Let's construct that. You construct. Let's make the students deliver the materials, which is something I totally neglected. To deliver the materials, that will make things easier. So yeah, at this point of the game, in the mid game, after you have your one level 4 darkness wand and 2 lightning wands that are level 4 as well, I mean, let's just say tier 2 wands for 2 lightning users. So the order is like this: 1 tier 2 dark wand user, 2 lightning tier 2 users, and you also need a fire one, of course, because fire is super important to cook. So another one for a wand tier 2 for fire, and after that you probably have one to really get a nature one, so you can cut the stupid trees. So the nature one will be next, and you may be wondering, what's next? Air, earth, or water? Well, it seems like the natural progression would be air. So at this point you need air, because air will build, and you'll need a lot of air to create the range. So in case you're wondering, how are we supposed to build something this tall? Well, the air mages will have a much bigger area to construct in. What does it say about this air? I guess we can just check the air one. Okay. So, create and move furniture around the school hall. And as you can see, I don't know why it says teaching over there. Anyway, just remember that this is also the range. Also, after that, you probably just need water, because water is needed in the alchemy station. Water. So water will probably be the last thing you do, because you can just farm the potions throughout the crystals. I think the developers at some point will just remove the crystals, or they'll just give them less rewards, because at this point you don't even need alchemy. But you should probably just prepare a water professor just in any case, and probably the last one you'll have to do is the earth one. Earth seems like it's the worst one, because this is for planting. The rune trees are for planting as well. Also keep in mind, you'll need some students to hatch these wonderful creatures: the Weaver Bird Nest and the Crone Bug Pen. Rose glass, ash parchment, and you also make run wood for from whatever resources you have over here, but it will be a little more annoying, because you'll spend your other resources. This guy over here, well, for now he can only make stone from wood. So this is not that good, not that bad. It's kind of like the middle of the road. As you can see, this is a school room, which is elevated, towered, lofted, and private. So it's basically everything you needed. And I say that, but I don't think we'll have enough room for a bed. Look at that, this is the fancy bed. I'm not sure how big it will be, but since the ladder is over there, we have a lot more room. So, again, this is not... We might need to have it two sides over here, because this will not be enough. So one door. Oh, you'll need... Oh yeah, that's the problem. So they even need the door. Huh. 25 luxury is not that bad because we just make 5 things around the place. 5. Five solemn pedestals. And let's say like that. And the other thing we'd need over here, three or more windows, and the windows are pretty easy to make. All windows. Ah, okay, so I can see this will be a problem because of the way the roof is skewed. Okay, wonkiness, like I said, is such a bad thing, it always annoys me. It ends up annoying me than help more times than I know, it ends up annoying me. Fibrous textual, I think it's still over here. I also modified the priority to have a higher number, so at this point we'll just make the fibrous textual very, very fast. Hey Moira, disintegrate that roof for me. That one as well. No wonkiness. Let's not question it. If it works, it works. And you can just have the kids deliver the materials and then you'll be okay. Just have Oliver build most of the stuff. Again, it depends on what you have over here, but that should work more or less. Now, I'm worried about the door. I guess if we need the door, then you just have to build it. Huh. Yeah, that will be a problem. I'm not sure how you're supposed to get elevated and private as well. Kind of annoying. And if you're wondering why are we doing this? Well, we're doing this because if you don't have a private bed chamber or a private quarter, it will not work to have, of course, these guys. The Vicky boys, the Raven cult. I'm trying to figure out what is the best tactic to create some rooms for them. As you can see, this is the house common already. So there's nothing bad that can happen over there. Room? Well, we have room. Are they feeding the bird? Yes, they are feeding the bird. Who keeps breaking my stuff? Somebody probably got upset at me. Now, as for the other stuff, just don't think too much about it. Because I'd like to keep a few dead people just in case someone goes crazy, because if they have very low conviction, we'll just do a ritual of a funeral, or we'll graduate someone, and the professor who does that, he'll have a lot of happiness. Well, some happiness at least. Para is outside. Huh. Apparently this doesn't count as a room now. Yeah, usually my biggest problems are of course with the roof. Let's wait for them to do this. Will that work? I'm really curious now. Okay, let's see if that will work. And by the time we finish that, this bird should have been finished with our refining needs. No? Needs feeding. What does this thing even eat? So, is it not in the order where you give it? Slope, we should have enough slope. We don't have enough slope, rats. And we don't have the slope because we need a fire mage with fire level 3. Very interesting. Okay, let's just hire Yuri for this task, and then we'll, I don't know, like I said, I'll have to reload this, because this is very, very hard to do. That's Historia was my fire mage. I kind of miss Historia, she was such a great mage, I guess. And this is kind of like where the bottlenecks start to happen. Because if you lose your fire mage, which would be your cook, it's going to be very, very bad. The thing is that I really wanted this guy to be my cook, because he can also cook. So I'll just have to reload the game, and like I said, in order to make something happen in this game, sometimes you need to plan for 10 or more minutes. Okay, Yuri's priorities will be easy. Cook all the time. Cook because you even have such a nice kitchen. I mean, look at this. Another problem is I cannot get enough bitter rice. I don't know why. Let me see. Potions, corpses, plant parts. Nope, nothing. No bitter rice was found. I guess the problem with the bitter rice is that it's continuously being eaten by the Croas, because this will sometimes run out of money and you have to recharge it. Feed. Action. No, it needs to be better. I guess you need all. You're always going to need a lot of students to do some of this stuff. Okay, it ate. And as you can see, the quilted carriers also will help with that. Oh, it's making them so fast. I like it. Yes, yes, tasks, good. That's going along nicely. Wow, this roof is giving me nightmares already. Let's see if that will work. Probably not, but we'll have to see. And these will have to be the ones that I'll have to make for later, so I guess we can just put them on a pedestal like this. So what's this to Y? To 3. It still doesn't count as a room. That's remarkable. Okay, let's try that again. The roof portion of the game is one of the more annoying ones. Sorry, you're wondering why did I elevate it? Well, because of the bed chambers always need to be elevated, at least in my case. I'm trying to see how much they need, because if I can just make them like this, I can make them like that. Then just have a little floor over here. Yeah, I guess this will work very nicely. That will be free over there. If the spiral staircase only needs to be... it works. If I want to make more floors... it has to be 5. Yeah, see? Now we're just winning, I guess. Yeah, they should really fix some of this roof stuff, but the roof is the hardest and most annoying part of the game. So when they start the task, I would really love them for... whatever. I would really love for them to finish it, so as you can see, you just have one that finishes one part, one that finishes one part, and in the end you don't end up finishing anything because they just leave. It's about the Wong. As that was just such an annoying adventure. Also, we should have the better bed, the fancy bed. Oh, why? Not ready yet. Hello, Lily Bloom, in case you're wondering, it's the one that you find from this grave, and I think the founder's grave as well. Yeah. Well, that's why I have some graves, so you need some graves as well. Just think of them as extra resources. And yeah, the bed over here, it will need 3 spaces, so that means the room needs to be 4 spaces. So if the room is 4 spaces, that means the wall or the foundation needs to be 6 spaces. That means this is all wrong. Well, I guess I should have left it as it was. Because that room will still be completed. That will work. Or... oh yeah, 3, 4. Then the wall over there. Then the roof with no wonkiness. Hey, this should do the trick. Now, as you can see, I'm not really focusing on the game because the goal of this video is just to make a proper bed chamber and to kind of show you how to build it in the date game. So I think you'll need about 4 private bed chambers because probably 4 of your staff will be very hard to keep happy. So I'm just preparing for 4 Beaky Boys, 4 Raven Cult. As they do the most amount of damage, and in my opinion, there's no point to have Wolfkin or Pebble Boys, because they're just not good enough. They don't do enough damage, they don't have enough skills, I don't know. It seems like the game has a little bit of a problem with this right now, because even the VV fight can be useless unless you have 3 or 4 of them. I think 3 is more than enough. Yeah, so this will have to be kind of like the way to do it. No point in working on that one. That it that oozes. They can only carry materials up to their own level, so that means they'll carry enough materials for bed, pedestals, doors or another stuff, but not for the roof, so yeah. That's going to be the hard part. So let's see this fancy bed, so... bed chamber, yeah. Private quarter, 25 luxury. And 3 windows. 25 luxury, that shouldn't be too bad because you can just make 5 of these. Or we can also make some rocks and some other stuff, but it seems like this is the easier way. This looks a bit like it's going to be ridiculous, but hey. Cook that, deliver the wood. Yeah, and even if you do what? What are you doing with that? Let's cancel that. So yeah, it's going to be a nightmare. So let's see, who is not delivering wood? Yeah, let's just build all of that. Okay, they're making that as well. So we'll need 3 windows from what I understand. Oh, come on. And now everyone leaves. Ah, it'll be okay. So after this, I'll probably do the same thing. So this side over here, one side will have probably the living spaces, and this side over here will be with classrooms. So private bed chambers, probably over here classrooms, and maybe here the woodcutter and some of the other stuff. And then I'll just have to make... Oh yeah, that's a very smart thing as well. Well, I don't know how much you know about the game or how much I know about the game sometimes, but we can even go further over here as long as you have the support columns, and I think later on will be we can even make this a little better. But the luxury, that's great, right? That's great. And that's everything we need. Yeah, the other one is going to be very hard to make with the canopy bed. I guess what would be the point to have it towered, but so if it's going to be private and elevated, it will almost all the time be the other ones as well. Because it has to be a length of 4, because that's the size of the door. That's a very nice bedroom. I guess you can still make a bedroom out of it. Oh, it's a normal bedroom, so that still will have 5. Okay, so the easiest way to do this is, as you can have 5 or 15 if you have the door. So it works even as this one. So you can just make 5 little rooms over here, which will be 1 tile less than the big ones. I am impressed this actually worked. Look at how beautiful this is. So depending on what you need, on how many you want to build of these, that's going to work very, very well, because I don't think we'll need more than 5 private bedrooms, because the rest of the teachers will not be as hard to satisfy. I mean, look at this, the stitched will be in this bedroom over here, and I think we'll send Farah to the farm, but Nick and Lisette will be with us for a very long time. And after that, we'll just have to fire some other people, and it'll be okay in the long run. That was great! Anyway, thank you for watching. It took me almost an entire episode to simply build private quarter. And yeah, for the other ones, like I said, it will be for the teaching, because the pyres and the other stuff are huge structures. Let me see what we need for those classrooms, just so I can be prepared. Lair of the Dark Arts. Oh, so it just needs stuff. It doesn't need to have anything else. Eye globe, obelisk, in the pinnacle. Yeah, I think those are stuff that needs to be added on top of it, so... Some of this will definitely need to have roof tiles. So I'll just have to go up with these two as well. And then I'll just build another row, and probably that will be it, because I don't think we can build over here, and that will be it. Also, let's look at another thing, because I really want the char cuttery, or the wood cuttery, or what was it called? Mage, hermitage, isolated. Isolated is silly, you just have to destroy and rebuild the entrance to it. Mage tower, and you probably don't even need these things, because scrivening and research rate at some point will become obsolete, just because you can do them so much better with not so much pain and headaches. Almost have a mage study over there anyway. Painting studio. Wand, shape, or trees. The trees will be the problem, because the trees are massive if you want to plant some of them. Let me show you. That's 3, so yeah, this is 8 in total. Sneaky developers, they don't want us to build 3 of these. 8 is the worst number they could have come up with. So yeah, over here we'll have the bed chambers, over here we'll have the classrooms, over here we'll have the woodcutter, and maybe some other things. See you next time, bye bye.